I want to talk about one of the principles of memory, just because you don't know it until you experience it. But it's actually a principle that I call the tiger in the jungle. And it's a survival mechanism. So when you start to understand that your memory and all of your mental functions are all there to help you survive. You know, at one time, life was not so, you know, so plush where we could talk nationwide, right. You know, and oh my God, it took a few minutes to actually get us to connect. But I mean, not too long ago, it would have been an impossible thing to do, period. Right. So because of all this progress, we don't realize that a lot of our abilities, every single one of them has a survival function. So Here's how it works. If you try to memorize something right now, your brain really thinks to itself, is this thing I'm trying to memorize, is that really going to help me survive? 9 times out of 10, most of the time, no. That's why you have to repeat the thing hundreds of times, because your brain doesn't think it's important. And importance to your brain is survival. Everything else is, you know, kind of pointless. Now, it may sound weird, but, you know, some things that you take a huge interest in, some things that you're passionate about, it could be some sort of geek culture or something like that, you could have great memory in. On some level, as hard as it is to believe, your brain actually feels like that's a form of survival, because that's something that you're very, very passionate about. It's something that you have a network of friends, you talk about it, things like that. So what the tiger in the jungle is all about is, say, imagine you were walking through a jungle and you see a tree and a rock and a stream and a nice little bush and another tree and a tiger and then a rock and then another tree and so forth. What are you going to pay attention to first? Well, doesn't matter how many different things there are, you're going to pay attention to the tiger first. In fact, you're not even going to notice anything else, right? Some people even stop me at tiger. And that's the way your brain works, is it takes the one thing that's memorable out of an entire scene and it holds on to it. It holds on to it like it's so precious. And I think anybody who's ever had a problem with your memory, you know what I'm talking about. When you seem to remember some things in an uncanny way, something is just triggers you so well. And you're like, why am I remembering that stupid joke? You know, but I can't remember this thing for this exam. And it has to do with that tiger in the jungle. On some level, your brain does not think it is dangerous or standing out from the crowd. It's boring. It's blending in.